Good evening. My name is Mark Kenlaw. I'm president at Rockingham Community College, and I want to welcome you to Rockingham Community College's EMT Academy Class of 2022 graduation ceremony. This is our first academy. We have partnered with the with Rockingham County for this special class that we have, this first class. And I can't thank the county enough for the partnership and for the need that we're trying to meet for our EMS personnel in our county so that our citizens can be served at the level that we need to serve them. And so I thank them for that partnership. I congratulate our graduates. We have eight of them. Eight students started the program, eight graduated, and all eight passed the state certification exam on the first take. That doesn't happen very often. That is incredible. So congratulations to our graduates. It's a testament to a lot of hard work by them. It's a testament of the support that you as family and friends have provided them. And so I thank you for being here to be part of this. It's also a testament of the hard work of the EMS program faculty and staff that you see listed in your program. A lot of behind the scenes work, but high quality instruction and support services throughout the academy. So a lot of good things to talk about tonight. So welcome again to our graduation ceremony. I hope you enjoy it. And so now I'm going to introduce Rodney Cates, who is our Emergency Services Director for Rockingham County.
Thank you, Dr. Kinlaw. I, too, would like to welcome everybody to our inaugural Rockingham County EMT graduation. Graduates, as I told you in the back, this night is for you. It's to recognize you for your hard work and your dedication. On this night, and many nights prior to this, we could not have been prouder of you and of your efforts up to this point. Your hard work and dedication do not end tonight. It only begins. So get ready for the ride. It's a good one. I also want to take a minute tonight to thank families and welcome families and welcome families out for this event. Families of public safety professionals play such a role in the success of their professional members. Families, those we come home to, you get to hear our joyous triumphs over a life saved. You hear our complaints over the inhumane conditions that we may have to see. And you also hear our cries for calls that didn't go the way that we thought they should go. Families are just as much a part of our success as our instructors are. So families, tonight we thank you for the support that you've given these people throughout the last 8 weeks of their lives. I also want to welcome all those who have made this night possible. This entire process began back in early 2022 with planning meetings, with the college, with human resources, with county administration, EMS staff. After many meetings, many ideas put on the table, most importantly, strong support from everybody that came together. The partnership between the county and the college that Dr. Kinlaw just mentioned grew even stronger, and we're here tonight with our first graduating EMT Academy class. The instructors, and Dr. Kinlaw mentioned them as well, they're listed on the back of your program. If an instructor is here tonight, as I call your name, I'd like for you to stand. Justin Stewart, who was a lead instructor, Ronald Hill, Jason Collins. Jason couldn't be here tonight, he's with his daughter. Natasha Bullens, Hannah Bouchard, she's actually on a truck tonight. Christina Iliano, Brian Ward was another one of our lead instructors. Mark Harris, I saw Mark a minute ago, there's Mark. Randy Young, ready, standing at the door. Stephen Edwards, I saw Stephen come in. And Avery Howerton, whom you'll hear from in a minute. Let's give these members a round of applause. Each of these members have adjusted their work schedules and their family schedules to provide training hours, training experiences to these students, and we thank you for that. I also want to thank tonight Rodney Stewart, Crystal Edwards, Jennifer Stanley, Rebecca Pretty. The food, the decorations, the setup, all of the things that you see in this room are a direct result of those four people. They've been preparing food all day. We've had to smell it all day. It smelled very good, and you'll enjoy it in a little while. So thank you all for that setup. So to the graduates, I want to share with you a few numbers. Those numbers are 38, 18, 11, 9, and 8. So what does that mean? We started this process with 38 applicants. 38 people put in application to come here. 18 people were selected to interview. 11 actually came to the interview. 9 were selected for this class. 1 had a scheduling problem that took him out of the class before it ever started. So we had 8, and as Dr. Kinlaw referenced, we have 8 people that sit before you tonight as fully credentialed North Carolina EMT Basics. Congratulations. On your first day of class, I wrote a quote on the board from an EMS patient that we had. That quote said, that should be a test question if you remember what that quote said. That quote said, "I will never remember their faces, but I'll never forget what they did." The quote is from a letter that I received from a patient who thought he was at the end of his life, but he wasn't, and EMS proved him differently. Just last week, I was contacted by a sergeant from the Sheriff's Department who praised an EMS crew for the care and compassion that they displayed on a life-ending call for service for an individual. Beginning immediately, because some of you are going on shifts Saturday morning, one goes on Saturday night, the rest of you go on shifts next week. So beginning immediately, you have the training and the credential to make these same positive life impacts on other people. So tonight I challenge you. I challenge you to strive each day to make these positive impacts, to continue your education and your training throughout your career, and be that person that makes a positive impact each and every day. Thank you.
Ask everybody to bow your heads. We pray. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you this evening to ask your blessing on these EMT graduates as they finish their EMT program and start their journeys as EMTs. We thank you for each one of them and their families that have supported them in the last 2 months as they've studied, learned, practiced, tested, and applied their knowledge. I pray that you protect them throughout their careers. I pray that you give them the knowledge and the ability to provide excellent care to all the patients that they encounter throughout their careers. I pray that you give them patience and understanding to deal with the patients and their families that they will encounter that will test and try them on calls. I pray that they will have integrity always to do the right thing. I pray that you give them wisdom and knowledge to know what to do in situations that everyone is looking to them to know what to do to help a patient in need. I pray that you give them humility to know that they're not in control of everything that you are. I pray that you protect them physically and mentally as they run calls that they will run over their careers. And lastly, I want to pray that each of these EMTs look to you for guidance throughout their careers, both on the job and off the job. These things we ask in your name. Amen.
I know you've already been thanked many times, but I'm going to thank you again for being here because we greatly appreciate all of your support that you've given us over these past 8 weeks. On behalf of the entire class, I would like to thank Rockingham County EMS as a whole, Rockingham Community College, and the Rockingham County Board of Commissioners for providing this opportunity for us, as well as the entire Rockingham County EMS crew, especially our instructors, for their time, energy, guidance, and patience. The Academy has been 8 weeks of action-packed learning. We've done so many lectures and hands-on activities and riding on the trucks. There was not a time where we weren't learning something new. One of my favorite lessons, as I'm sure many of us remember, is the first driving lesson with Mr. Rodney Cates. I'm sure he will corroborate this, but learning to take curves for me involved a learning curve, one curve specifically. And in that moment, my classmates also learned the importance of seatbelts. My classmates and I, we quickly realized that the best way to learn all of this new and important information was to practice doing scenarios in class where we could actually put them to use. And just earlier this week, we found ourselves in different terrains where we had to figure out the safest and most efficient ways of transporting patients to areas they can be effectively treated and transported. They gave us unique insights as well in these situations to how this feels for patients in these times. And for example, I know now how it feels to get taken out of a tree, which is very exciting. And Tiffany knows how to be taken up a hill. So it was just very valuable to see how we affect patients in those scenarios. All of my classmates and I, we come from different paths. We were medical assistants, bull riders, stay-at-home parents, and I myself was a college student. But over these last 8 weeks, we have truly become a team. One of our instructors told us that the joy of teaching new EMTs was not the PowerPoints, it's not doing the TSOPs or the practice, but it was seeing a group of strangers be able to become a capable and efficient team. The EMT Academy has not only given us a new opportunity to begin new career paths, but create lasting bonds and skills that will grow stronger over time. We're excited to put everything we have learned into practice. Lastly, I want to congratulate my classmates. I know these past few weeks have been stressful and exciting, but we all made it here, and I am so proud of all of us and excited for all of us to get out there and start doing things. We've come a long way, and we're going to go even further. I know it. Thank you, and I would like to invite our guest speaker, Avery Howerton.
I just want to say I'm very proud of y'all. What y'all have accomplished is it's amazing. And I want to say thank you to each and every one of you for the attention y'all gave me when I came in to teach. Y'all showed me that y'all had the passion and the desire to want to learn this and get out there and start your new careers. And I was honored to be your teacher, and I'm not going to stand here and take up all your time tonight. But I want to give a round of applause to these students. They've done amazing things. They come in with a positive attitude, and it has grown, and they are truly a team. Can we give them a round of applause? And I was honored to be your guest speaker. Presentation of candidates for graduation, Mr. Ronnie Hill. Thank you.
As I read your name, come forward and accept the tokens of your accomplishment. Benjamin Brooks. Sadie's Calder. Eric Matthews. Justin Rogers. John Hsu. Brian Simmons. Tiffany Stooks. And Joshua Wilkerson. Again, let's give them a round of applause.
How many times can we say thank you? One more time? Yeah, usually I write something when I'm going to do this. And I just thought, nah, I'm going to speak from the heart, because I have been with these guys from the day they were interviewed till tonight, and I just feel like I'm so vested with you all. I have seen them grow from that nervous candidate that sat in front of us into these professional, on-time, polite individuals in that building, in our Owen Simulated Hospital, and they make me so proud. I go by and I speak to them every time in the building. They're so nice, they're so professional. And the one thing that I want to say in my closing remarks is, you all are why we do it. Students like you make me want to get up and come to that college and teach every day. You make us want to do it. You're great, and I am so happy and proud of you. Family, friends, you should be so proud of them and so happy for them. They've been through a lot, and they have just, like, stuck together. They've been great. So thank you for attending, and we're going to have some food and some reception. So please join us. Have pictures made with your group pictures, with your families, with the Christmas tree, and enjoy tonight. Tonight is about you and these graduates. Thank you.